Only one tool is what you need to be able to work faster and also smarter. Let's jump into it. So the first thing that you have to do, just enter GitHub and look for AutoHotPie. Once you are here, just go down and select releases. And after that, if you select the last alpha, just download the last executable file. So just go through the normal installation. So I want to show you how I will do this using ZBrush as an example, because we are artists. So let's be practical about it. So the first thing, make sure that you have AutoHotPie already enabled. We're going to create a new profile, and then we're going to give the name of ZBrush in this case. And to first, you need to select the application. So let's get to focus window. So in this sense, just select the window of the software that you have open here. And after that, just go ahead and select the profile. Once you have the profile, you need to create a pie menu. So here we're going to make an example of brushes. It's very important that you already establish the shortcuts inside ZBrush, so you are able to already tell HotPie which shortcut is which button, right? And also for the selection color, we are going to go for a color that is closer to ZBrush, so it's kind of obvious that I'm within ZBrush. And also you need to make sure that you establish already here the shortcut. I'm going to establish something like a control shift right click for now. Later on you can change it, let's see. And then just go ahead and add the pie menu. I'm going to go a little bit through here. So first of all, you have global where you can select the text font, and also the size. To be fair, nothing of these settings, I get to touch it. I really don't care about it. The only thing that I really need to touch is the appearance, and it's mostly about the label roughness, just to make things just nicer, visually nicer. And after that, all these menus here, you can play with them, but they don't really add any value. So the most important are the functions. So what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to create the shortcuts for my different brushes. So what I will do right now, I'm aware already of the shortcuts that I'm using. So I'm going to choose every single brush. I'm going to start, name them. So start name them. Icon for now, I'm not going to set it up. I will show you later where you can download icons. And then when it comes to function, just make sure that you send the key and you press exactly the shortcut that you have established in ZBrush. So I'm just going to go around it. This. So also you can add and delete different menus. So if I hover into any of them, I can add a new one or delete them. So I'm going to right now just delete it and keep it simple. So after that, you have different ways to go around it to test it out. You can save and run, or also you can close it and automatically it's going to start already saving everything. So let's get back to ZBrush and test it out. So right now I'm just going to make sure that I have every single shortcut already working. Everything seems correct right now. So I'm just going to test it in a quick scope. So I'm just going to create a happy face. Let me go for the standard and me create something. And right now I want to select my damn standard and everything seems to be working fine. Let me go for my H polish. Everything's to be working fine. And one of the cool things about it is that AutoHotPie, it also works with hand gesture. So not necessarily you need to go ahead and select the button, but the only thing you have to do is just move it in the right direction. Once you move it in the right direction and already understands where is the placement of that button, and you can just switch. This way you can just work way faster than you were doing it before. So Plasticity is an excellent software to create a hard surface, but it's horrible when it comes to shortcuts. And here is where AutoHotPie just come in place, very handy. Currently in Plasticity, the only way to get to common actions, you need to press F, and then it already has an action assignated. But without a hotpie, you can create pretty much everything just with different submenus and events of menus. So for example, one thing that I never like is the fact that sometimes I want to activate the X-ray mode. So right now, the only thing that you have to do is with a AutoHotPie, just do it. Or for example, I want to get rid of the wireframe. So I just went ahead and do it as well. So let's say you want to create a pipe. So right now in the old way, you need to go ahead, either press Shift 8 on your keyboard or select here, and you can go here. Let's try to make it round. So I will need to create a fillet. You can also press B in your shortcut, but you need to look for it in the shortcut. And also you need to create a pipe, which is pressing B, if I'm not wrong, and then just go ahead and do it. It's not fast enough, but if you use AutoHotPie, it's just way faster. So right now what I will do, I just go ahead, create my line. So if I don't run, I have line here. I have my fillet here. You can see already how fast I'm working. And if I want to create my pipe, I just literally through hand gestures, I create a pipe in maybe 10 seconds. I don't even know, but it's very, very fast. And one of the cool things about AutoHotKey is that you can also establish submenus. So for example, if I want to create a symmetry, I will need to first activate symmetry and select then the axis. So right now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go ahead, translate this guy in the y-axis, and then I'm going to create symmetry. So right now, if I go to my actions, the only thing that I will need to do is just go ahead, click symmetry, and then a new submenu will show up. At this stage, I can already establish which is the right, you know, plane that I want to do. Upset operation, and that's it. As simple as that. Another great example of a great use of AutoHotKey is also in Unreal. So let's say, for example, I want to get rid of the game mode. Normally, you will need to press G on your keyboard, which I don't quite fancy that, but if you also assign it, you can just go ahead and create a shortcut. I love to create different shortcuts here in Unreal. One of the ones that I really like is looking for the asset. A lot of times, I have the character and I need to look for the material or I need to look for the mesh. So I will just go ahead and then I just look for my asset and automatically I will have it already in my content browser. Another one that I really like is jumping into full screen. So I will just need to go ahead and go and select full screen. So it's very handy and it's super useful. And you can imagine how fast you can even work in Unreal using AutoHotKey. And another great example about how to use AutoHotPie is in Blender. There is one specific shortcut that I never like in Blender, that is the one for framing, where you have to hit the dot on the numpad. But for example, just by using AutoHotPie, if you select the box, for example, in this case, and enable it, now it's just way easier doing it comparing to the other methodology. And again, I will just use whatever I feel like is necessary. For example, transform. I prefer working with the transform icon. For scaling, I think it's just way easier doing it like this. Full view as well. Very, very important for Blender as well. Or wireframe, you know. At the end of the day, it's all about working faster. And another way to use AutoHotPie is also with Rizom, for example, that is a software that is great to create UVs and packing them. So let's say I want to access, for example, just the vertices. I can just go ahead, right click, select vertex mode and or go in here, or just through AutoHotPie and hand gesture, just go ahead and select them. So this way, it's just way easier. I just want to show you quickly how I set up some of the other softwares that I just showed you before. So if I go back to Plasticity, that is the original one that where I felt like is super powerful. I want to show you specifically about how I did the symmetry. So one of the cool things about it is that not only under functions, you can set the send key, but also you can set the submenu. So by just doing submenu, then you, in edit submenu, you can create all these new operations within it. And the great thing is that in this case, it makes total sense if you need to choose the symmetry. Another cool thing is that you can create a whole bunch of different shortcuts depending on the type of actions. So I normally like to divide all my softwares depending on the actions. So and I normally divide in navigation and then action. So navigation would be mostly selecting vertices, edges, faces, and whatever is more related to the viewport navigation. And then actions is pretty much every single thing that you need to go through commands or very complex commands. Through navigation, I try to be as simple as possible. And the cool thing is that in some cases, at least in Plasticity, a lot of these actions are spread out in the viewport. So you need to go ahead and select them. But this way, just through hand gestures, you just work super fast. And last thing very important is I think it's about icons. I can't operate with an icon there. I believe that it's easier for me to understand where is the icon located before actually reading the word. So I would suggest to you strongly to jump into this website. It's called iconarchive.org. And the cool thing about this website is that you can pretty much search anything. So let's say, for example, you need an unfold icon. So you just need to go ahead and type unfold. And there you're going to find a whole bunch of different icons that might be related to it. In some cases, actually, it's unfold itself. What you need to do is choose icon, and then you have different options. You can either use their stock icons, which is very good, but it's also very limited, especially for 3D artists, where some actions are just very strange and crazy, like bridge, for example. How you define bridge with an icon? Go through icon archive and start finding all the icons that are more related to the operation that you are creating. And the great thing about Icon Archive is that you can download everything already in PNG. So it's pretty much ready to go. Make sure that you plug it on the right folder. So you have this button that is called Manage Icons. And then once you are in the right folder, you set up everything there. Super easy to set up. And you literally can use it for anything. I also have shortcuts for Windows. So let's say I need to jump into Documents. So I just go ahead, select my downloads, and that's it. You are already in the download folder. You can literally AutoHotPie everything. So that's it, everyone. Now you have the right tool that is going to fasten your process so much, you can't believe it. And something that I really like about this tool is that all of a sudden you're going to think differently because you don't need to look for the actions. You don't need to even look for them in the keyboard. Now it's just going to become a hand gesture and you're going to get very creative when it comes to creating all these menus and submenus. So if you like the tip, consider subscribing, smash the like button below the video, and I hope to see you in the next one.